Hello friends, I'm Paulshinn from the YouTube channel that's making Model A's cool again. Today we're going to be talking about brake fade in the Ford Model A and how to prevent it. What is brake fade? Brake fade is when you step on the brakes, the car is slowing down, but you're on the brakes a lot and you notice that the brakes aren't working as well, so you push a little bit harder, slow the car down, and then the brakes get hotter, and then you have to push a little harder. Pretty soon you're in this death loop where you're on the floor and the brakes aren't working at all anymore. So how do you prevent that? There's a couple of things. Number one is driving habits. Number two is the hardware under the Model A. So this is a Ford Model A stock brake drum. Now this has a front hub in it. Pay no attention to that. Right now, let's talk about the brake itself. So this is a rolled steel brake drum. This was from the beginning of production right through about September of 1931. These are the brake drums that came on the Ford Model A's. These are steel. And the way they work is a brake shoe, this is an example of a bonded brake shoe, pushes against the side of the drum. So you have two brake shoes, they push this way and that way against the drum when you push on the pedal, and that is what slows the car by putting friction against the outside of this brake drum. Here's an example of a woven type. But so let's talk about these brake shoes for just a minute. As these are pushing against the side of the brake drum, these are generating heat. So it's converting the forward energy of the car into heat. That heat has to go somewhere. What it does is it builds up in the drum. Now, you remember from, I don't know, third grade science, that when things get hot, they expand, and when they cool, they contract. Well, what happens when a brake drum expands? It gets bigger in diameter, right? The more heat in this drum, the bigger it gets. That means that the brake shoes have to push out even more to make contact with the drum, and on, you get into a vicious cycle. So at some point, this thing's gonna get so hot and so big, there's not enough travel anymore in the brake shoes. They're not gonna make good, firm contact with this, and you're not gonna have any brakes. So how do we fix that? Well, there's a couple ways. We'll get into driving habits in just a minute. But first, we're gonna talk about brake drums. So one of the early fixes was to add these bands to the brake drum. So this is a stock steel brake drum, and it has these bands added right here like this. These are pressed onto the brake drum. It is just a press fit. These do a couple of things. Number one, this extra steel around here helps prevent the drum from expanding when it gets hot. Number two, it uses these fins here to help dissipate the heat. This helps a lot. You can rejuvenate a set of steel drums with these bands, and they're actually pretty usable. But Ford had a better idea. Starting in about September of 1931, he went with cast iron brake drums. So the cast iron brake drums are pretty obvious. There's no rolled anything on the edges. These are just basically cast iron, just like a pan you'd cook in. A lot thicker material here. You can actually turn these down and true them up a little bit within reason. But what these do is, number one, they expand a lot less when they get hot. But number two, there's so much more meat here, it takes a lot more heat to make them expand. And even when they do, they're still good gripping. So that's why a lot of people convert their Model A brake drums over to these cast iron brake drums. It makes a big difference. Plus, if you use the bonded type of brake shoes against these, man, there's a lot of friction there. People that say Model A brakes don't work well, they've never tried bonded brake shoes and cast iron brake drums. That really makes a big difference in helping the Model A stop. The next thing is to talk about driving habits. And to do that, we're gonna get in that Model A, and I'm gonna tell you how. Hey, any excuse I can come up with to take a Model A for a drive, I'm all about it. Model A's make people happy. I've said it before, it's true. Model A engine is designed to put out lots of torque at low RPMs. That means that your shift points are going to be a lot lower, and it's going to have really good engine braking. So number one, let's start out by talking about shift points. So first gear is really just to get the car rolling. Once the car is rolling, grab second. And then second gear, hold that until you get to about 20, 25, depending on what you're trying to accelerate to. Then grab third. Now let the torque pull the car up to whatever speed you want to go. Don't over rev the Model A motor. Remember, the red line's somewhere like around 2500 RPM, so you want to keep that RPM down. Use the torque to pull the car. So as I come up here to this corner, I'm using all engine braking to slow the car. I'll just hit the brakes a little bit. Downshift to second to finish slowing down and then accelerate out. I barely touched the brakes for that. So coming up, we're going to be going on a really long downhill. I'm going to show you how I can go down that hill without ever touching the brakes once. And that's the key, to stay off the brakes. That's how you avoid brake fade in a Model A. Okay, so watch. As I get ready to go down this hill, I'm going to downshift to second, and I'm going to let the engine braking slow the car down. Now, you look, I'm not even touching the brakes. We're going to head down this hill. Even if we do start to pick up a little speed, I can just get on the brakes just for a short second, just to kind of control the speed. But right now, the engine's doing all the braking. We don't need to go 50 miles an hour down this hill. This is a residential area. So we're going to just creep down it kind of nice and easy. Not even have to touch the brakes. So far, look, my feet aren't doing anything. They're just holding the ends of my legs up. That's all they're doing right now. So the other point that I wanted to make is when coming to a stop, Model A versus a modern car, I see a lot of people, they just take it right out of gear and let the brakes do all the work. In the Model A, I'm letting the engine do the work. I'm not even taking it out of gear until I'm almost stopped. I'm still in third. Okay, now I'll take it out of gear. So that's the key, leave it in gear. Don't be in a hurry to get it out of gear. Let the engine finish stopping the car. Okay, coming up on this curve, I'm gonna get on the brakes more than anything, just so the brake lights come on so the people behind me know I'm slowing down. Get on the brakes for a little bit. Now what I'm gonna do is downshift and let the engine do the rest of the slowing down, get around the corner and then accelerate out. So you see, I wasn't on the brakes very long. So now coming up to this stop, just gonna leave it in third. I'm not taking it out of gear, not yet, not yet, not yet, now. Okay, see, only the last 10 feet or so of that stop was all brakes. It was engine braking and brakes up until that point. Okay, coming up, we're gonna have to get on the highway, which means I'm gonna have to really accelerate fast. So I'll show you where my shift points are gonna be. The shift points really aren't gonna change. The only difference is I'm going to get to them faster. Okay, it's clear. Here we go. Okay, now I'm just letting the torque pull the car up to speed. Once I get to about 45, I'll grab overdrive, we'll take it all the way to 55. Just like that. Model A's can totally keep up with modern traffic. No sweat. Okay, so from 55 miles per hour, slowing down, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take it out of overdrive. Let the engine do the braking in third gear, straight through, coming up to this corner here. I'm not even going to touch the brakes until I'm just about to the corner. Now I'm going to downshift. Let the engine do the braking through the turn. I'm going to climb this hill right here. I'll just keep it at about 23. Now at the top of the hill, I'll grab third, and then let the torque pull me to whatever speed I want to be running. Okay, coming up to this corner here, I'm going to do this without even touching the brakes. So all I'm going to do as I come up to this corner is I'm going to downshift and let the engine do the braking, make my turn, and then accelerate out. Didn't even touch the brakes for that. Driving a Model A is different than driving a modern car. You keep the RPMs low, you let the torque do the work, may the torque be with you. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope this helped you, and I'll catch you on the next one. What are you still doing in my shop? Go, work on your car. Remember, your project won't work unless you do. I'll see you later.